interesting thing. But yeah, it was a good time. I saw a lot of cool cars. I think the highlight for me, there was a GT3 RS there. Well, I think it's called Lava Burst Orange. Beautiful car. But there were a bunch of really cool ones. There was a couple of Vipers. One of the new Vipers, but it was in the kind of the classic blue with white stripes colors. That was really cool. And yeah, it was pretty good. Welcome back. I'm on the highway, almost in Portsmouth. Just cruising along. Traffic's actually really not too bad. I'm using eco mode. I'm getting 31 miles a gallon right now. It's pretty flat. And yeah, just cruising along. I'm gonna go right through downtown Portsmouth. So there's gonna be a fair number of people there. And then the coastal drive is just awesome. This morning while we were at the Cars and Coffee, we kind of parked out back, and there was kind of a father with two little kids walking along, kind of coming by the car right when we were getting ready to go, and the little kid was so excited to see this car. He was like, do a burnout, and he's like, watch out for us, and he was like squealing excited. I didn't do a burnout, obviously, but gas, pretty good for him, and he was so excited. He was like through the roof. So that was pretty cool. One of the things I like most about having this car, it's the first sports car I've ever owned. It's definitely, I'd say, the highest performance of any car I've ever driven. I've ridden in a couple other real fast cars, and I rented a LP570 in Las Vegas. I drove on Las Vegas Motor Speedway, and I get that car has more horsepower, but it doesn't have as much torque, and it's a similar weight, and it didn't feel as fast as this thing does when this thing accelerates. Now, it might be this has a little more drama or something, with all-wheel drive might temper that down a little bit, but man, this thing is fast, and I'm happy. I'm enjoying being a little bit out of break in and getting chances just to accelerate, really, go through first, second, maybe third, but then, back it off, save the high speeds for the racetrack, which hopefully will be forthcoming at some point. Right now, I'm honestly just getting used to the car. Got my seat all set up. It's like a million way adjustable. I like the heating and air conditioning in the seats. The air conditioning especially. I think it's just venting cooler from the air conditioning system. I believe it pulls in from under the seats. Pretty nice. Especially if you wear jeans or something on a hot day, and you can stick to some leather, but under those seats you actually are pretty good. I really like the boy button for eco, track, sport, touring, rain. The sport track modes, they open up the exhaust, and the baffles definitely, really, you can hear it. You get two of the four exhausts open up in addition to the other two that are already open, and really changes the sound of the engine. I don't think the sound will come through real good on the GoPro, especially not without the microphone, but definitely, kind of coming films, I'll be having a microphone and I'll get some sound clips so you guys can hear it. But the speed limit's 20, and I am literally going exactly 20 miles an hour. And she thinks I'm going a lot faster than I am. Yeah, it's pretty slow through here, but it's scenic and it's relaxing, so that's actually why I like it. Yeah, so we'll see.
Thing, it's just not my jam. So I'm on a metal rate.
looking at the car, and he had to go off to the side. Now, don't get me wrong, I realize this isn't a Ferrari or Lamborghini or anything, though, performance-wise, it's not so far off. Some of the road and track, Lightning Mile, better than an RE, better than a 570S, going around a track. I think 570S, don't quote me on that. Anyway, lumbering V8. One of the things, even though I know it's not one of these, exotic cars, it has definitely a presence to it, especially with the Grand Sport with the wider front fender flares. It's something that really, like, seeing it in person, photos don't do it justice, but a Z06 or a Grand Sport, it's like 3 inches wider and then on the rear, where the tires are to accommodate, they're 335 rear width tires, it's 12 inches. It's hunkered down, and those rear tires are wide. The back is definitely very squat, and it has this presence to it. Combined with like the LEDs on the front look very similar to some of the Ferraris, where it's a line coming towards you. Same with the blinker, it's a vertical line of LEDs. People can't help but look, and I think it's a great looking car. I'm partial, obviously, I bought one, but I tend to look at these just as much as I would look at a Porsche or a Ferrari or something a little more exotic. And so anyway, that jogger, he literally ran off the road. He's angling along, and then he realized he was not on the kind of the running and biking lane, and then cut over real quick. All right, back to V8s. One of the things that I've never had a V8 in a car. I've had a V8 in my first vehicle, a Chevy Silverado, like mid-90s vintage, as a first car. Nothing crazy, just a working V8, not a performance one. But one of the things I've liked about this car is it's good at any speed. You're cruising along at like 20 miles an hour in second or first, and it just idles along there at like 1200 RPM, maybe 1500, and it just lopes along. Oh, I want to pass something, or I need to merge. Give it a tap of the gas, instant torque, instant power, and you're already catching up or passing, whatever it is, and honestly passing, because this thing is fast. And then you want to go fast at a higher speed, keep it at higher RPM. This thing is smooth, and it has power for days. I really can't express how much power this thing has. I know the Z06 is an extra 190 or so. The LT1 that's in this, 465 horsepower with the performance exhaust that it comes with, it is awesome. It's like the perfect everything car. Get on the highway, put it in eco mode, drop it in seventh, and you're at like 1400 RPMs on the highway at 70, and you're getting 30 miles a gallon if it's flat. You want to go fast? Drop